this late stage of the season, how hard is it, Greg, for teams not to look ahead to the playoffs and the postseason at this point?
Kevin, just about impossible. I mean, if you're already in position, the trap you can't fall into is easy up down the stretch and backpedaling into the postseason.
Let's check out Seattle's starting lineup. Trey Lyles out there with Holmes, and it's Fox. Then there's Harrison Barnes, and it's DiVincenzo in a shooting guard. And the Nets with possession here. Seattle able to drain the three, and Curry has it in the corner. Drives to the hoop, and the layup's good off the glass.
At 6'11", with his passing skills, Simmons will always find the open man.
And you love seeing that great Mobile One drive a second time.
And the awareness of his footwork and body on that drive. Wow. And once he got to the 10, I think he was surprised to find himself that wide open.
Easy possessions like that literally are just a gift. You just dream of them. You'll gladly take them.
Here's a from outside.
And Simmons is just the total package. I mean, a player that can really dish it to his team.
And it's Fox with the jam.
Look at the handles. Gets through the D and then powers it home.
Such a pretty move inside. Clark, how do you stop that? Great. Ben Simmons, one of four players in the entire history of the NBA, to average at least 7 rebounds and 7 assists per game through his first 4 seasons.
Think about it, Jody. Magic Johnson, Oscar Robertson, and Luka Doncic. That is some pretty elite level company.
With a short break in the action, gives us a chance now to send it over to David Aldrin.
Thanks, Kevin. Yeah, Seattle's head coach and I did get the chance to chat. Talk to me about the importance of protecting the rim, challenging opponents at the top of the jump, and making it difficult for them to convert easy baskets. But to have a chance of that, they have to expend energy getting back in transition, which will help close down those driving lanes. The guys will see where their energy lies throughout this game.
Thank you, David. Simmons. And Simmons slams it in.
And no issues getting up to Simmons. An emphatic 2 points from the ice right.
Seattle has gone 1-3 from beyond the arc so far in the game. Wasted no time on that one. DiVincenzo's got a couple of threes now in the first for Seattle. Curry passes to KD. Curry setting the pick for Durant. Back to Curry. A three ball. Gets the 3-point defense. Curry's got 11 points.
And they're getting their points now almost exclusively from the triple. 4 of their last 5 mates are from beyond the arc.
Now, here's Fox. He's an offensive force, averaging nearly 26 points a game. The shot's good from DiVincenzo.
The real come at us, and we're coming right back at you.
Yeah, I love the competitive fire right there. You drain a triple on us, and I'm coming for my revenge.
And the first timeout called of the game for Brooklyn. Big group substitution here for Seattle. Lance checked in for Rashawn Holmes. Terrence Davis comes in for Barnes. Suggs, he's checked in for Dante DiVincenzo. And it's Mitchell in for De'Aaron Fox.
And their offense already in a flow. Some stellar shooting to jump out to this lead.
The three from Davis. And again, Seattle with the triple.
And he's not going to miss that sort of an opportunity from deep.
And Harris wide open. He shoots. And it's good assisting on the play with Simmons.
The goals are starting to add up, guys. Out of their last 5 baskets, 3 have been triples.
And here's Davis for 3. Rebounded by the Nets. Coming off that loss against the Timberwolves.
Well, and that one, you could pretty much see the writing on the wall. Their performance was lackluster at best.
Yeah, I just didn't see any fear from them to want to get it back. That's just one of those games you throw away in the trash and try and forget about it.
Here's Mitchell following the bucket by the Nets. And Davis gets it to go. Davis has got his second bucket.
And both teams here in a nice rhythm offensively, and that really says as much about the lack of D as it does either's O.
And that one, good.
Punch, counter punch. Impressive offensive production early on.
You have to think at this point the winner will be the one to settle in on defense.
Hits the 3-point bomb. Davis has got 9 points.
out of their last five makes, how about all five from long range?
Simmons against Mitchell. Thomas down low. It's hauled in by Lyons. Right side Davis. From the arc. Good on the three-point shot. 12 points for him.
And this is the game plan for him. And he's a big part of their floor space.
And so it's Seth Curry making highlights for the Brooklyn Nets. He comes away with 11 points in the quarter and is showing no signs of fatigue. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. And getting going again here in the second quarter. Fairly close game so far. And some stats here, guys. The scoring breakdown for Brooklyn. Joe Harris is out there with Ben Simmons. And it's Durant. And it's McCloud. And at the four-man position. So that's the Nets five. Fox kicks to Len. Fires for three. It's hauled in by Harris. And it's Harris, the ball for the Brooklyn Nets. Their biggest lead of the game was nine. They're playing host to Toronto for the next one. They find themselves in the middle of this string of three straight at home.
Well, if you like guys who can work that in-between area, really keeps the defense honest.
And when we talk about the numbers, the analytics for great shooters like him, pretty much any shot is a good shot.
Passes it to Davis. From deep three-point range. Rebound, Brooklyn. This game against Seattle is the first time they've met this year.
In their meetings last year, they split the season series. Happens a fair amount between teams from the East and West.
A somewhat surprising split. One team made the playoffs and the other was lottery bound.
And Ben Simmons, the epitome of a point forward.
He passes it well and plays huge for a guard at 6'11". It's crazy. It is very rare to see a player of his size with his skills.
It's time now to hear from our Hall of Fame reporter, David Aubrey. That's the latest, David.
Thanks, guys. The Nets have tremendous talent, of course, but there have been some challenges. KD says, I know the fans have high expectations for us, but if you're a fan, you'll appreciate Nets basketball and what we're trying to build, and you'll follow us along this journey, because you never know what may happen. Kevin, back to you.
Great. David, thank you. Out of bounds. Seattle will take possession.
Let's just say they weren't on the same page there. Not sure he was expecting that pass.
Sharps checked in for Brooklyn. Seth Curry comes in for Simmons, and Seattle also making a change. Holmes checked in. Seattle has gone 2 of 4 from three-point range so far in the second quarter. A three for DiVincenzo. Good, and it's Fox who picks up the assist. Fox has got 4 assists now tonight. Curry passes to Durant. Curry a screen on Davis. The high post shot for the three, and the Nets another three.
Seen several lead changes tonight. Neither team giving an inch.
Up on the edge of my seat, courtside. Man, this has been a barn burner.
12 straight points off of three-pointers, and the D looks shell-shocked.
Curry gets to Durant. Back to Curry. Launches it. 6 for 6. He's yet to miss from the field.
Will we come at us, and we'll come right back at you.
Yeah, I love the competitive fire right there. You drain a triple on us, and I'm coming for my revenge.
Hits it from three-point range.
The defense a step slow, and you can see the result.
And De'Aaron Fox gets the whistle that time. That is his first foul of the game. And different games, different officials. Something that might be called a foul in one game, Greg, may not be called in the next. As a player, how do you adjust to that?
It's a great question, and that's part of being a veteran. I learned early on, you actually scout officials the same way you scout the players. They have tendencies as well.
He was inside his own head in that first quarter. You could see it. Now he's doing a much better job of letting the game come to him.
And here's DiVincenzo from the arc. And another three for Seattle.
Having a lot of trouble stopping the three-point shot.
Curry passes to Durant. Curry setting the pick for KD. To the inside. Sharp. That one doesn't drop. Good work defensively by Holmes. Davis finds Holmes. Wants to get it to Barnes and does. And here's DiVincenzo from the arc. It's good from long range. DiVincenzo's got the lead up to 5 now for Seattle. DiVincenzo against Kirk. Near the 3-point line, it's Thomas. And Kirk got the end of that time as it falls.
And despite the hot start from beyond, they've gotten away from shooting the triple.
The 3 from Davis. That's in, coming off an assist from Payton. Davis has got 27 points.
You thought that first quarter was good? He's been even better in the second.
Durant up top is guarded by Davis. Outside curve. Shot clock at 6. There's the triple. And the Nets, another 3. Passes the shot, and then Sharp with the dunk.
Smart dish by Durant, giving it away to a guy with a quality look.
DiVincenzo kicks to Davis. Got it off in time. No good on the last second attempt there. So that'll be it for the first half.
Welcome, everybody. Let's jump right in with a look at the players of the week. In the East, Giannis Antetokounmpo.
Well, the Greek Freak, always a great pick for this award because he's so consistent. Gives the team an anchor on both ends. He's always getting better, and his teammates love playing with him. Such a great guy.
And when we look at the first half for the Nets, a close contest so far. And that's all for us. Now it's time to send it back to Kevin Harlan for the beginning of the third quarter.
And after a fairly even first couple of quarters, the second half could turn out to be a great one as both teams try to gain an edge. You know, Davis has been exceptional here, guys.
Man, he's been running wild on them through that first half. Absolute dynamite on offense.
If they don't change their approach in the second half, I'm just going to say his success will continue.
Second half underway. Here's a new Collins down on the floor. Got Rashawn Holmes. Terrence Davis is out there with Lyles. Then there's Dante DiVincenzo. And it's Fox in at the point. If in the last couple of seasons, Rashawn Holmes has mastered the push shot.
It looks a little bit unorthodox. I'll give you that, but you can't argue with results. Within 16 feet, Holmes is automatic with that push shot, especially out of the pick and roll.
Nets trail by 8. Simmons passes to KD. Oh, here's Shaq. And it's Fox with the rebound. To Holmes. Outside, Davis. Bangs home the trifecta. Davis has got 5 points in the quarter.
This man has entered the zone. Great shooting performance from him all game long.
There's the screen. Here's KD. Shot. Great positioning on the putback.
And folks, he did not lock into that one. He knew just where he wanted to be to grab that backboard.
Seattle calls timeout. In addition to going over the game plan and making whatever necessary adjustments have to be made, Greg, this timeout also the time for players to get rehydrated or hydrate for the first time with some Gatorade. Plenty of basketball still to be played here, and they have to get recharged.
That's a great point. Without proper hydration, a player can completely run out of gas down the stretch of a game, and that's something that none of these guys can afford to have happen. If you're going to battle all the way to the finish, you have got to be hydrated.
Catching up on the changes for Seattle. Suggs comes in for Davis, and it's Mitchell in for Dante DiVincenzo. Harris outside. To the paint, here's McLeod, and he floats in for the easy 2. Good at the assist on that one.
And that tells the tale here today, guys. Throughout this game, they've been able to get the ball in tight and finish.
And that one's good, Mitchell.
Yeah, great outside shooting, really fueling this run.
On the wing, Harris. And here's the drive, and screened up by Harris.
And just punch the ticket on that one. That'll get the job done.
Powerful two-hand jam. Holmes can't get it to go in.
Just enough resistance to force the miss. Barely. That's one he'll generally make.
And the Nets, Richard, are trying to build a legacy where they're recognized as one of the league's true glamour franchises.
And they've got the star power and they've got the market. You got an ownership that is willing to pay for it. They will do everything, but ultimately, it's going to be the players and how they perform on the court that will dictate how this success is viewed.
The infrastructure is there. Now can they get the players to fill the role? Oh, what an impressive dribble drive. That replay brought to you by Mobile One.
And catching the defense flat-footed and taking full advantage. Big bucket there to extend the lead.
And while we've got a moment, I'd send it over to our terrific reporter, David Aldridge. David?
Thank you, Kevin. Well, Kevin Durant learned an important lesson at age 11. His dad hooked him one-on-one, dunking on him and talking trash. Durant started crying and he locked himself in his room, but came to realize, what am I so mad at? It's good to be passionate, but channel it. Once you're off the court, leave it and go back to being you. Kevin.
Good advice. David, thanks. Thomas checked in for Brooklyn. And then for Seattle. Harrison Barnes, he's checked in for Lyles. And Gary Payton has subbed in for Fox. That's good, and the Seattle leaders got down to 11 on the bucket from Harris.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Here's Schultz. It's held in by Harris. And Schultz-Harris will bring it up for the Brooklyn Nets. Outside for Thomas. Good. And Harris gets the assist. Harris has got 3 assists in the game.
A quality pass setting up a quality shot. It's just textbook basketball.
Payton in the corner. It's up a 3. Carries the long-range jumper. Payton's got himself going there. His first points of the game on the deep ball.
How about dueling from long range, just going at each other?
Take that, he says. I see your 3, and I'll raise you another 3.
Simmons can't get it to go. And stolen by Simmons. Driving to the basket. The 3, Harris, and the Nets, another 3. 52 seconds left here in the third quarter. Mitchell against Simmons. Mitchell kicks to Suggs. Out to Payton. Shoots the 3. And another 3 for Seattle.
It's been this way since halftime. Tremendous production from beyond the arc.
In the modern NBA, you have to hit 3s to win games. And they've made that adjustment since the break.
They set the pick. Thomas goes in. Here's Hammonds. Outside for Simmons. 5 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. 2 points. That one goes. Hammonds got 4 points now in the quarter.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Here's Mitchell. And a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot 2 here.
And you don't ever want to get into the habit of letting the offense get to the rim.
Seattle shooting their 3rd and 4th free throw shots of the night, and he makes the first. And Mitchell drops them both. And so it's Seattle holding on to an 11-point cushion as we get ready to take a break. Their lead is where it is because they've gotten good shots. A lot of good shots. We'll return shortly. And let's take this opportunity now to show you our State Farm assist of the game.
And he sliced the D wide open with this feed. They had no chance to prevent that basket.
That's an unguardable pass, flat out. Give him credit for possessing that type of vision.
And there may not be a lot of drama down the stretch as we head into the fourth quarter, but stranger things have happened. We've got Thomas, also Seth Curry out there. Sharp out there with Durant, and it's McClung. They have to force it. So that's the lineup for Brooklyn. In the corner, it's DiVincenzo. Jacks up a 3. It's good for the 7th time this game. He's shot 7. He has made 7.
Well, he's been doing it all night. Why not go back to it?
Yeah, just keep feeding him. That guy is a man on a mission. And the defense, well, man, that lucky is. The offensive rebound with a little extra punch on the putback.
You're right, Greg. As they look to trim the deficit, could we see them send a few more bodies to the board from here on out? Maybe, just maybe. Pass to McQuan. Let's it go from deep. That one falls, coming off of Thomas's feet. Thomas got 3 assists in the game. Seattle calls timeout. Ben Simmons, he's checked in for the Nets. Rashawn Holmes, he's checked in for Seattle. Suggs comes in for Gary Payton. Time now to turn to our sideline reporter, David Aldridge. David.
Hey, Kevin. During the last break, I heard Seattle's coach as he addressed the team. He wants them to maintain their balanced attack, but he told them they're doing a great job of finding space out on the perimeter, which has led to all those good shots. He likes the rhythm and the flow of this offense. Just told them, keep shooting it with confidence. Kevin?
All right, David, thanks. Antony's a very efficient 5-for-6 on the game.
You want to know why they're winning? It's because of his play offensively.
Simmons passes to KD. That's good. Basket number 5 on a 5-for-8-night shooting.
And he's really shot the ball well, but it hasn't been contagious.
Fox. It's good. Now he's shooting 6-for-7.
The defense comes at Fox hard, but he's ready for it. He knows how to stay agile and nimble inside.
And the jam by Kevin Durant. Good. Once again, that makes him 8-for-9 this game.
And really, as the three-pointers keep dropping, you get the sense that the frustration is mounting for the defense.
Here's KD, and it's good assisting on the play with Simmons. Simmons got his assist totals piling up, 11 now for him. Here's Fox. He takes it in. Count that one as his 7th make in 8 attempts. A scorching 88%. Durant deciding where to go with it. McQuan. And what do you guys think so far about the offensive approach for Seattle? First one falls for. And so he makes both from the line. And the media is able to vote on awards like all rookie, but Greg, those awards can end up determining a player's max salary. Any concern?
No doubt there is, but somebody has to decide those awards, right? And no matter who it is, there's always going to be some pushback. So as long as contracts are tied to them, that power will be in someone else's hands.
Timeout call, the Nets. Harrison Barnes, he's checked in for Jalen Suggs. Nets trail by 12. Here's Durant. Nice passes to Shaw. In the corner, Simmons with it. Just found the shoot. Floats in the hook shot.
And the closer Simmons gets to the rim, the more dangerous he becomes. I love watching him in attack mode.
And here's DiVincenzo from the arc. No good. Only a second less than 10 attempts from the floor. Here's KD. So the first one drops, and that brings them within single digits.
You look at Durant's game and you instantly see all the hours of hard work that went into shaping it. He's so polished in every area. His skills are so sharp.
And the Nets making a change here. Curry's checked in. Fox with it. Guarded by Simmons. And he'll shoot free throws here. Clearly fouled on that shot that time. The whistle blew.
Yeah, nice strong finish there. Nearly a three-point opportunity. You gotta love how scrappy De'Aaron Fox is. No matter what kind of challenges he faces in a game, he's never giving less than his all.
And so it's KD with it. He brings up the ball for the Nets. Seattle grabs the miss.
And we'll just watch the clock wind down, guys, in what will turn out to be a win here for Seattle.
If they had to battle for this win, there were times when it looked like it was maybe slipping away a bit, but they never let that happen, which I thought was a real credit to them.
And that's a product of their mental toughness. Anytime the flow of the game turned against them, instead of caving, they just dialed it up a notch and were able to pull away.
And I think a great job in positioning themselves for the W here. It's win number 21 on the season. The one player that really stands out, of course, in this one, it was a dazzling game for Davis.
He came up with a bucket every time they needed him to. Great effort on offense, and he was a difference maker.
Curry passes to Simmons. Hit stolen by Wiles. Here's Barnes. Put it down! Wow!
Oh, my gracious. Wow. Way to get up.
And they came in determined to take this one. It's going to be a happy flight home.
And as it should be, to be this dominant on another team's floor, look, when you go home, you're going to go home feeling good.
And Durant, here we go. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line. Harrison Barnes picks one up.
That's a strong move there by KD. He knows he's going to get the bucket, get fouled, or get both. He doesn't matter.
Well, KD's still a net after asking for a trade. The team looked, but didn't feel the deal was there. And Durant will continue to play. But you feel like this story could drag on until the trade deadline or beyond. Saw the opportunity to put this away and did not turn it down.
And that score probably slams the door for any would-be comebacks. And look, they put this one to bed.
And that was the last thing they needed. Now the clock is stopped and they put them on the line.
And he makes both free throws. The three from Davis. It's hauled in by Harris. To the wing on the left. Here's Hammonds. Good. And Harris gets the assist. Hammonds got it back down within single digits for the Nets. Here's Davis. And it falls. So no problem for Seattle as they get the win. They came in here and took care of business like they were the home team.
And Carol, how about the...
Inside the locker room, everyone trying to lock in, get mentally ready for another. And at this point, we're just about halfway through the season. Some teams, Clark, playing great basketball right now.
And the real challenge is to maintain that if you're one of those teams, to continue to play at a high level, to continue to trust and put in the work to perform.
Now the starting group for the visitors. Rashawn Holmes is out there with Trey Lyles. Then there's De'Aaron Fox. Then it's Dante DiVincenzo. And it's Barnes in at the three slot. Outside Barnes launches a three. Here's Fox. Second chance effort. And he sinks the layup.
Man, I like how confident Fox is inside. I mean, awesome. Absolutely awesome. Getting good positioning close to the basket.
Here's Milton. It's off the back of the rim. No good. Pass to Fox. Takes a three. Sinks the tray. Fox has got five now.
Starting to find his rhythm. He's cooking, and he knows it.
And you know what? They're going to keep using him. I mean, he'll be the centerpiece of their offense today. You can bank on that.
And Philadelphia calls time here. Korkmaz has checked in for Milton. The 76ers have gone 1-for-3 so far. Harris's shot is good.
Well, this is the threat that Harris poses now. He's a scorer from every level. Inside, three-point land, and at the rim.
You know, in the past several seasons, there's been one constant with the 76ers. They're going to be among the best defensive teams in the league.
Maxey with it, and it's Holmes picking it up. And down it goes! Jam that one home!
Great job on the back end of the play.
Yep, finished with both hands, making sure of it.
Yeah, highly efficient, nothing extra special there, just effective.
The Sixers' identity really does center around their defense.
It's so true, B.A., and they've done a great job playing to their strengths. That's the key for any contending team. Maximize your players' talents. Philly has done that as well as anybody.
Here's Embiid. Uses the glass to finish the layup. Embiid's got his second basket.
Showing off the superb handles for a seven-footer, Joel Embiid handles that thing tight.
And that was the mobile one drive. Low resistance to the finish line.
And I love the way he played downhill on that drive. Love the attack mentality in a close game.
Slams it down with two hands. Man, they're really getting aggressive now.
Now's the time to do it. Keep attacking that rim.
And defensively, you have to make him work harder than this, or it's going to be a long night.
You really don't want to allow him to get too comfortable, but even with stifling defense, he's going to still find a way to get it in the basket.
Here's Harris. Oh, Fox for the steal. For the finish. And Fox powers it home.
The defensive instincts of Fox. Man, scrapping and clawing for every steal he can get. Great speed with his hands and feet.
Maxey passes to Harris. Thibel with it. He's guarded by Barnes. Outside Maxey. And there's a pick. Rebounded by Fox.
Does not get much easier than that, but somehow he came up empty there.
Pass to DiVincenzo. And he can't extend the lead to double digits.
He didn't make them pay for that weak defense, but they just can't rely on him to miss those kind of shots.
This is really amazing. I mean, from March 1st, 2014, to October 26, 2016, Joel Embiid didn't play in a basketball game. 31 long months. Rehabbing back and foot injury.
Bamba's checked in for Philadelphia. Kaminsky comes in for Tobias Harris. And it's time for an injury report.
They might struggle to fill in the games ahead. Guys.
Okay, thanks for the update. Good to get that information. Now we know how things are coming along, Grant.
That's true. It's the uncertainty factor with injuries that could be so hard to handle.
And, you know, for him, just watching his teammates unable to contribute, that's really a helpless feel.
Thibel, that's good.
They're punishing those late defensive rotations, getting good looks inside throughout the half.
Pass to Suggs. Beyond the arc. The rebound by Maxey. The 76ers have gone a fantastic 8 of 11 so far. Takes it inside. And a powerful
slam.
They keep trading punches. Both teams in a groove early.
Hey, guys, this is going to be fun now. I mean, we've got ourselves a shootout on tap here.
Outside Mitchell. Pass to Suggs. Clock at six. Davis from long range. Hits the trifecta. Davis has got six.
Boy, good vision that time from Suggs on this play. Finding the most ready shooter and fed him nicely.
Here's Korkmaz. Mamba, pass to Maxey. And again, it's Philadelphia.
And he's coming off a huge performance, and his confidence couldn't be any higher. And his coach knows that, too.
Showing no signs of slowing or cooling down. We're going to ride him as far as he can take it.
And at the end of one, both teams putting up some points. They're up by two. And quarter number two will get underway just after this short break. And this has been a fairly close game through the first quarter. We'll see what happens here in the second. And what do you guys think about the visitors here in this one?
Well, it seems like they went in looking to do damage from long range, and they faced little resistance.
And you know what? That's what happens when you establish your three-point game early. Puts the defense right up against it.
Jalen Suggs out there with De'Aaron Fox. Then it's Trey Lyles. Then it's Terrence Davis. And it's Lynn in at the center position. Here's Jordan. Oh, and makes it with the kiss. Jordan's got his first basket of the night.
I tell you what, it reminds me of one of my college coaches who used to say, that ain't gonna get it done. That's five straight baskets in the paint now.
Davis, that's good.
A dozen consecutive points off of threes. This defense looks rattled.
And guys, now that they're rolling from out there, the defense has to really get up into them. You gotta almost be in their jerseys to try to deny those looks.
Here's the three. That shot off the mark. So Philadelphia will take it the other way.
And they dominated this team last season. Big difference in talent.
Well, you know, they swept the season series a year ago. The expectation is they'll do the same thing again this time around.
Joel Embiid, he's checked in for Kaminsky. Rashawn Holmes, he's checked in for Seattle. DiVincenzo comes in for Suggs. And from the sideline, let's catch up with Allie.
Brian, Sixers head coach Doc Rivers earned the nickname Doc back in college for wearing a t-shirt with Julius Erving on it. In the NBA, he said, quote, the first game I started was against the Sixers. I went over and said, Dr. J, how are you? And he said, Doc, how are you? I said, no, no, I'm Glenn. But he said, no, you're Doc. And that made me feel like I'm the inbox.
All right, thanks, Sally.
He's just too big, too powerful, too skilled. Not worried about whoever's defending him at all.
76ers have gone 2-4 here in the second quarter. And Embiid throws it down.
Bang, kept it simple. No reason to get fancy right now, B.A.
Yeah, he's just looking to find shots and produce for his team.
Hey, I thought there was some style there, guys. What are you guys looking at? I mean, it was still a pretty sweet, flavorful one-hand flush.
You know, in baseball, Graham, they have a term, a five-tool player. In the NBA these days, it's similar. You need those well-rounded players to succeed.
Ah, I like the baseball reference, but you're spot on, B.A. It's all about bringing versatility to the game. Players that can shoot, pass, dribble, defend, and rebound. And I'll throw even in there, lead and play selfless basketball. Those kind of guys that can do it all, that's a recipe for success. The NBA.
And the 76ers another three.
Well, this is something that Harris has really enhanced in this game over time. Hard work, paying dividends.
And the 76ers with some changes. Bamba's checked in for Jordan. Korkmaz comes in for Harris. And it's Tyrese Maxey in for Thybulle. For three, DiVincenzo knocks down the triple. DiVincenzo's got 8 points.
Rise and fire. DiVincenzo does not lack confidence going right up with the shot.
And Milton, here we go. And he gets it to go.
We've seen that more than once today. An effortless basket inside.
Well, listless and lifeless at the defensive end. I mean, especially inside. They've really got to pick up that interior defense.
That's been typical of their performance today. They're sharing the ball and creating good shots.
Really a prime example of the difference in how these teams have operated offensively. Much more individual play at the other end.
On the wing, Milton, three-pointer. Another three for Philadelphia.
And
This is just fun. These teams are trading threes back and forth.
Nothing like answering back. One team gets three, you fire three of your own.
The last season's scoring champion, Joel Embiid, the first center to lead the league in scoring since Big Shaq way back in the 2000 season. Willing passers, unselfish play. You have to appreciate this kind of offense. Fires the three. Peyton's shot is good. He's got six.
They're getting torched on the perimeter. Four of the last five buckets have been threes.
It's hard for me to watch this. I mean, the defense practically giving them those shots.
Embiid.
Again, the Sixers score.
A chance at a two for one if they'd like.
And I really can't see why they wouldn't.
Outside Barnes. There's the triple. Ooh, he's looking comfortable now. Three for three.
Three-point shot has been his weapon of choice this quarter.
About 7 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Maxey against Holmes, and it's Maxey missing. For Seattle, they've gotten 8 of 12 attempts to drop since the beginning of the second. And here's Mitchell. Now quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game. Here's Payton. No good. Misses at the buzzer. And so a close game as we wrap up the first half of...
You look at their bench production, so valuable to have guys that can come in and contribute the way that...
Next up, the power rankings. Let's take a peek at which teams are at the top of the association. That's it for us.
As we get into this third quarter, as we've seen so far, neither team able to create much separation on the scoreboard. Boy, Terrence Davis is really making a difference here.
Well, if he's hit threes like he did in the first half, he's going to have a monster night.
Yeah, you know what? The defense is going to adjust. They'll be ready for him now, so I'm sure they talked a lot about how to slow him down.
Harris and Embiid are playing up front. Maxey out there with Shake Milton. And it's Thybul in at the three, the small forward. That's Doc Rivers five as we get into the second half.
Adjustment time for these guys. The defense has to make some adjustment here.
Maxey against DiVincenzo. Another three for Philadelphia.
He's bringing a lot of energy to this offense. Not letting the scoreboard discourage him right now.
Well, I tell you what, the hole would be a lot deeper if he wasn't being as efficient as he's been so far. Well, he's cooking with grease. He's got things flaming up, looking for an opportunity every time down the floor when he's that hot.
Embiid from outside. Drains the triple. Embiid's got 13.
Well, you know, that's the kind of competitive spirit Embiid plays with. I mean, if you knock one down on him, he's looking for you the next trip down.
Here's Holmes. That one goes in.
Good, solid start to the half, hitting three out of four.
Philadelphia has gone a perfect 5 for 5 from deep tonight. Pass to Harris. And a hand on it. And there's the bucket. Staying with it that time. Offensive glass getting it done.
Yeah, you know, Harris is an active player. I mean, he's smooth and he's skilled, but he's also a guy that's got some grit and grind to him as well and gets in there and keeps possessions alive.
Jordan's checked in for the Sixers. Kaminsky comes in for Harris. It goes again. His sixth basket in 7 tries.
They're on fire right now, shooting 80% to start the second half.
Here's Milton, offline with a baseline jumper.
Boy, he's got to be disappointed in the result there. I mean, the defender really didn't make any impact at all.
And keeping us updated from the sideline, out in the force.
Thanks, B.A. Well, Joel Embiid drawing comparisons to some legendary big men. He said, quote, "I want to be mentioned as one of the greats. That's my goal. And obviously being a Hall of Famer. But you've got to take step by step, one day at a time. It's going to take a lot of work, and I'm willing to put it in."
well on his way, Ali. Thanks.
You know, Jordan's size is part of the reason why he draws as many fouls as he does. They just have a tough time getting through his body without fouling.
And the 76ers making a change here. Korkmaz has checked in. Seattle has gone 2 of 3 from outside so far in the third quarter. Pass to Suggs. The three sends it home from three-point land.
Hard to win games when you allow clean looks from the perimeter.
You're exactly right. I mean, those come back to bite you every time, just like it's biting them now.
Back to Korkmaz. There's the three. Knocks it down from distance. Finals got five.
Man, this is just fun. These teams are trading threes back and forth.
Nothing like answering back. One team gets three, you fire three of your own. Boom.
He's been playing great, unselfish basketball. Really putting the rock in the hands of the right shooters.
He is delivering a lot of room service dimes tonight. One sweet one after another.
Maxey passes to Thybul. And here is Maxey. And he goes in for the dunk.
You know, big guys like Jordan who can facilitate are really valuable. Spots the open man and gets it right to him.
And the shot goes. 15 points in the game.
And just not letting up at all. I mean, you have to love this approach. You want to get the ball to the guys who make plays.
If it's working, keep working it. That's what I say. Keep the pressure on.
And Philadelphia calls time here. Boy, Terrence Davis is really making a difference here.
You know, that defense is helpless right now. I mean, he's got their number, and he knows it.
Bamba's checked in for Philadelphia. Taking a look at the last 10 games. Here are the players who have been flat-out dominant scoring the ball and showing no signs of letting up anytime soon. And you look at Davis, the fourth best scorer in the NBA. Man, can he pour it in?
He's been on an absolute tear offensively. He's found something that's working for him, and he's sticking to it.
Oh, and he got fouled on his way up. He'll head to the line to shoot two.
And the improvement of Tyrese Maxey's three-point shot from his first season to second year, just unprecedented.
He improved by over 12% with a huge increase in attempts as well.
Tobias Harris checked in for Thybul. Both free throws good from Maxey. And for a player with the speed and quickness of Maxey, Grant leveling up that three-point shot changes everything for him.
Oh, so true, B.A. It becomes pick your poison with him. And it put him in a conversation last year for most improved player.
And he drops a first. That's also good, so he hits both free throws.
Staring at this deficit, they're trying to be more aggressive and get themselves to the line.
That's exactly when you need to be aggressive. You know that. I mean, another good job, though, of drawing contact and getting to the free throw line.
And he drops in the layup off the glass. Payton's got 11 points.
It's not easy to work the ball inside in this league, but they've done it all night.
Maxey passes to Harris. It's a three-pointer.
And over time, as his game has evolved, Harris has accepted a bigger, expanded role. Knows he has the green light.
Pass to Davis. That one falls. Nice setup by Mitchell. Mitchell's got 5 assists tonight.
This defense just can't stay connected to shooters.
Outside Maxey. Kaminsky outside. No luck on that one. Ooh, excellent D there from Barnes. On the wing, Davis. The three. Philadelphia grabs the miss. Left side, Maxey. Spotted away. And so it's Seattle, closing out the quarter ahead by 11 points. Great shot selection right now. Keeping the game simple and getting high percentage look. And let's take this opportunity to show you our State Farm assist of the game.
You can count on him to deliver a few assists like this one each and every night.
It sure is. I mean, he's a maestro. Great vision, terrific IQ, everything you want in a point guard.
Well, there may not be a lot of drama down the stretch as we head into the fourth quarter, but stranger things have happened. They've got De'Aaron Fox. Trey Lyles is out there with subs. Then it's Rashawn Holmes, and it's DiVincenzo in at the two spot. Five to shoot. Embiid's got space. Oh, he finds himself wide open and drills it.
Tell you what, I don't know if any center in the league can score in as many ways as Embiid. Maybe Jokic, but those two are pretty much in the class by themselves. Embiid showing us everything.
And he probably thought he was going to blow it out. Milton with it, and it's Holmes picking him up. And he's outside. Another three for Philadelphia. That's his third triple of the night, his second since halftime. The three from Suggs. And it's Harris with the rebound. The Sixers trailing to the middle. Here's Milton. Oh, some solid defense from Fox. Seattle has gone 0-for-2 from outside here in the fourth quarter. Who wasted no time on that one.
And the three-point shot of DiVincenzo is dangerous. Defense cannot allow him to get airspace from there.
Harris passes to Embiid. And Embiid with the pass.
His playmaking is something to watch. Threading that pass right in there.
The three, DiVincenzo. Doesn't go there. Now he's 6-for-9. The 76ers have gone 3-4 in the fourth and looking confident on offense.
And what an aggressive move to the rim. He's really trying to fire up his teammates right now.
Boy, it's not hard to feel inspired after a teammate makes that out of
the finish. You know, when you're looking to close the gap, you need guys who will take it upon themselves to step up, take the initiative, and make something happen.
Pass to Embiid. Now here's Harris. Here's Embiid, defended by Holmes. The jump hook. Another shot. And the finish by Embiid as he lays it in. Embiid's got 9 points here in the second half. The 76ers making a switch here. Maxie's checked in. All right, let's get a report from Allie.
Hey, guys. During that last break, I heard Seattle's coach as he addressed his team. He said to his players, you may want to get comfortable with this lead, but we can't afford that. That's when we get in trouble. Just keep executing the game plan and trust one another.
Allie, thank you.
Fox never afraid to take it right at the defense on the drive. Excellent display of speed there.
The 76ers have gotten 5 of their 7 shots to fall in this final quarter. Melton with a screen on DiVincenzo, out to the right wing. Here's Embiid. Drops in the layup for 2. Embiid's got 21.
You like Embiid's confidence and willingness to step up in the big moment.
Here's Fox. And Fox powers it home.
Look at what he's doing here. And it's hard to imagine him playing much better.
Well, that might be fair, but I wouldn't want to take away from what he did in that last game. I mean, let's just say it's a pretty nice run he's on, no matter how you decide to frame it up.
Controls the rebound.
I know it's a tall task, but you've got to box out in the game. It's really that simple, because if you don't, he's going to make you pay.
He clipped the ball there, but not enough to nab the steal.
Clearly a careless pass. He got away with one there.
Barnes, he's checked in for Suggs. It's Fox for the drive.
Handles the Fox. Nasty. Remarkable at carving through the defense and creating shot opportunities for himself.
1:15 left in the fourth quarter. Here's Milton.
Go, Sixers, go. Go,
Sixers,
go.
Outside Doxy. And the mid-range shot is up. And then Embiid with the dunk.
Oh, nothing soft about that.
Was not going to be denied. Just took the dunk that was right in front of him.
Well, you know, if nobody can put a body on him, then that's going to be the result.
And a foul called on Harrison Barnes. That's his first foul of the game. We've played just over 3.5 minutes now in the fourth quarter. Milton against Fox. 14 feet away. Kept alive. Embiid.
Love the way Embiid knows how to play with force down low, which in turn makes the defense get physical with it.
He drops the first one, and that shrinks the margin to just 4. And Embiid drops him both.
He knows just how important these shots are, and he makes them count.
for three. DiVincenzo. That one's good. 7 for 10 now.
Woo-hoo! Yes, DiVincenzo. What a gamer. Somebody who lives for these kind of big moments. Watch out.
There's a need. It falls. And now they trail by just 4.
What confidence from Joel Embiid. Knock that one down in a clutch situation.
Ball distribution was there. I mean, outstanding work all the way around.
And Philadelphia calls time here. They're losing by 6. There's 47 seconds left in the fourth quarter. There's 47 seconds left in the fourth quarter here. Here's Thybul. And it's in.
Man, where's the effort on the defensive end?
You gotta play harder than that.
And you know, it's made for a fun game, but you're right. You're exactly right. I mean, the defense has been non-existent.
The three, DiVincenzo. And he gets it to go. He's 8 of 11 now.
They have a relentless mentality, even with the game in total control.
And you know, until that final buzzer sounds, I mean, you gotta treat every possession like it's crucial.
Embiid can't hit. No need to shoot. This one is done.
Yes, they've got to be happy with tonight's effort.
Outside, DiVincenzo. Pass to Fox. Back to DiVincenzo. No good. The visiting club takes the win on the road. This was a hard-fought, well-earned victory for them. They had to dig deep to come out on top.
Yeah, you know, some teams might buckle under the pressure towards the end. The crowd was so amped up, such a hostile environment. But they stood tall and got the win.
Thank you for joining us. That'll